They will have the very soon.
Let him finish.
Do you believe for a moment what he's telling you?
When we finally do, God willing, get a who's going to take the shot? Who's going to take the shot? You can be the first one to say, put me, sign me up. They now say it's okay.
So let's just say there's that is approved and even distributed before the election. Would you get it?
Well, I think that's going to be an issue for all of us. I will say that I would not trust Donald Trump.
You're going to say to the American people now, here's a it was new, it was done quickly, but trust this federal administration and their health administration that it's safe. We're not 100% sure of the consequences. I think it's going to be a very skeptical American public about taking the and they should be.
We can't trust the president and take his word and take a that might cause harm to us.
If and when the comes, and it's not likely to go through all the tests that needs to be and the trials that are needed to be done. And the question is he going to seek emergency move?
Frankly, I'm not going to trust the federal government's opinion. And I wouldn't recommend to New Yorkers based on the federal government's opinion.
If Donald Trump tells us that we should take it, I'm not taking it.
Now that he's gone and we have Democrats have done, we've watched them do a 180 on the and now they're shaming you for saying the exact same things that they did. And that's what happens when politics infect our discourse about the pandemic. And one of the biggest aspects of this politicization is the rise of corporate censorship. So you have political agendas that are causing legitimate debate to be stifled and opinions to be censored. And that's causing another crisis, a crisis of confidence, a crisis of faith in these government institutions that Americans no longer trust, especially our health agencies. Because that's what censorship ultimately does. It undermines the very institutions who are doing the censoring, most of all. And because thanks to all of the censorship, people begin to suspect that something's up. They think maybe we're not being told everything. Maybe there's some kind of agenda. And then people start to dig in their heels and really, truly resist. This is why censorship is dangerous. And we all know that the censoring of Americans is happening. But think about what it's doing to our personal and collective health as a country. Yes, censorship affects your health very directly. And this politicization and censorship coming from the left isn't limited to coronavirus. Here's a recent tweet just from WebMD. It reads, quote, sex should be removed as a legal designation on the public part of birth certificates. American Medical Association, AMA, said Monday, end quote. Now, do doctors suddenly believe, like altogether, that there's no biological sexual reality? Of course they don't. But there is intense pressure from the LGBTQ community to pretend that sex doesn't correspond with gender. Now, good medicine depends on doctors being able to act in the best interests of their patients, and they can't be kowtowing to some woke gender ideology. Doctors must be able to acknowledge biological reality, like the difference between boys and girls. After all, medicines, like antidepressants, for instance, they affect women and men differently, sort of hormones, actually. So should they ignore these biological differences to please activists? Should they censor the truth about biological sex, only if they want their patients to be harmed? Yet doctors are increasingly afraid to tell the truth. This same kind of chilling of free speech, that's what's happening when it comes to the mRNA. So just a few weeks ago, we were told everything's safe and effective, remember? Now we're told, well, maybe it's not as effective at stopping transmission and infection of variants like we thought. But if you would have said this just like a week or two ago, like reporter Alec Berenson did when he saw rising infection counts coming from the very highly countries of Israel and the UK, well, you'd be deplatformed, which of course he absolutely was. How about the notion of viral immune escape? This is a theory that variants may actually be caused by mass. Well, of course, I mean, you're going to have mutations. I mean, it's a theory that no one is supposed to ask questions about, discuss, educate on. After all, that might create more hesitancy, and we can't have that. We know that if we keep people completely in the dark and don't answer their questions, that encourages them more, said no one ever. Yet we've never tried to mass the whole entire world at once with mRNA that still are going through the whole validation process. And some virologists fear that it could maybe perhaps be putting selective pressure on the virus. Maybe it's mutating thereby making more resistant strains. I like there's another one called the Lambda. Well, that's what's being suggested. Evolutionary biologists like Brett Weinstein, they've been demonized simply for asking questions about viral immune escape. And I'm not saying that Brett Weinstein is right. I'm just saying that why are we so afraid to consider Weinstein's concern? That's also shared, by the way, by Dr. Robert Malone. Who's he? Oh, just the inventor of the mRNA. And by the way, he's been receiving death threats for putting this viral immune escape theory forward. So why can't their theories be discussed? I mean, after all, what if the creator of the mRNA, what if he's right or even kind of right? It's our health at stake. Can we not talk about it at all? Are we just gonna discount the theory? Have the CDC show us why a given theory is wrong? I mean, remember, many of these same experts suggested lab escape was the most likely origin of the virus well before Legacy Press acknowledged this possibility. And these scientists were deplatformed for suggesting it. But now even the Biden administration admits lab escape is a very real possibility. And speaking of lab escape, if it's a bioweapon or a lab-made virus, don't we need to kind of talk openly about that? Don't we need to take steps to ensure that gain-of-function experiments are not done again? And certainly not with our tax dollars at a lab in a communist country who is our enemy. And we don't need to talk about sanctioning and suing the CCP for possibly causing a worldwide pandemic that killed millions. What about the coronavirus therapeutics? There's some therapeutics that field doctors have had tremendous successes with, like ivermectin, that are a part of early treatment protocols that work. But the CDC doesn't seem to have much of a recommendation on early treatment protocols to offer. So if you're infected with the Rona and you're told to stay home and wait and hope the infection resolves, but for some, they end up very sick after it progresses, and then it's straight to the emergency room, where then they're often put on a ventilator, which isn't good. Yet all generic therapeutics are discounted, and the CDC's only treatment seems to be mask up and shut up. That's apparently the one and only policy they have. And why will that name alone, ivermectin, why does that get you tossed off social media? I honestly can't tell you how many friends I've had that have been suspended temporarily or permanently because of that. Is it because it's an off-label generic drug that makes the approval of maybe an in-development impossible? If you mention that idea, you'll totally get censored. And the problem with all of this, it's our health that may suffer if we can't hear different opinions or even speak truth. Now rumors of mandated for the military are imminent, but there's no discussion about whether this is appropriate to do or even allowed. If mandated do happen, it'll likely cause some of our best servicemen and women to leave the military rather than be forced to take an experimental that they don't need, especially since hardly any soldiers, show us the numbers, because it doesn't look like not even in double digits. So of course, you're gonna have another hit to the military. And again, because the left politicized the pandemic like the left politicizes everything, the government ends up having to bully and censor people who resist, which means we're no longer following the science. We're following some kind of political agenda, one that the administration doesn't seem keen on sharing with us. And so when people ask questions about that agenda, they're censored or they're told that they don't need to know the answers, trust us, and that's what happened in this exchange between Fox's Peter Doocy and Deputy Press Secretary Karine Jean-Pierre. Watch.
President Biden says that we are not returning to lockdowns, shutdowns, and school closures, but he also once said that we didn't have to wear masks anymore once we were. So why should Americans trust him now?
Well, because we listen to the scientists, we listen to the expert. This is a public health situation. This is not about politics at all. This is about saving lives. And this is what the president is all about. He wants to make sure that we are saving lives. If you look at Peter the last 6 months, that's what he's done every day. And you see that in the numbers. Now we're at a point where we have to double down and make it very, very clear to people that we can't let the pandemic win. We have to continue to fight.
She's way nicer than Jen Psaki. But this, too, by the way, is a form of censorship because they're not transparently sharing the data behind their policies. And this is where censorship in America is taking us, to no place good. Didn't have to be this way. It hurts everybody because it creates distrust and resistance to government policy. Corrupts health agencies because they're not being held to account for their words and actions. It turns Americans against each other because we're essentially saying there's only one right way to think about these very complex and nuanced issues. Finally, all of the politicization and censorship, it's hurting our ability to navigate a crisis and come out the other side united. Censorship is un-American. So whatever the difference is about masks and therapeutics or passports, people need to be able to freely discuss it. Enough with the censorship. right? People need to listen to each other and not demonize each other. And we better get busy doing just that before it's too late.